So principle number one is know your vision. When I speak to people who say they're really ready to create their ideal life, I reckon the first thing they need to do is to work out what their vision is and then really commit to it. In other words, you need to consciously choose where you're headed. There's a Sufi saying, if you don't know where you're going, then any road will take you there. I just love that. If you don't know where you're going, any road will take you there. I often hear people say things to me like, yeah, I want more money, I want more freedom, I want to have more success in life. But when it actually comes down to them really taking the time to get to know and to crystallize their vision they have for themselves and that ideal life, they don't really have enough clarity behind what it is they're looking to achieve, which makes it difficult to commit to. Originally, I was driven to make more money with less stress and fewer working hours. As I became more involved in the SFM and through workshops such as Brand Incubator, this has really helped me to have a much clearer picture of what I want to achieve, particularly around my passion for prostate cancer and men's health, both physical and mental. So this is the first principle I see as being very significant, because if people don't actually really invest the time to think about the life they want to create, what often happens is they end up leading a life that falls short of their ideal life and the life they'd imagined for themselves. Let me explain what I mean here. Most people think, well, if I've got heaps of money, that will solve all my problems. And now that I've got money, I'll be able to lead the life I've always dreamed of. In reality, though, people often end up building businesses that they think are a great opportunity to make money. But what it turns out to be is something that isn't going to give them the lifestyle that they'd imagined. The business brings with it more stress, longer hours, less time to do fun stuff, and less time with family and friends. So what I suggest is for people to really, really think about what their average ideal day would look like and look for a business that supports that vision. So what I'm talking about is for people to really think about that when they wake up in the morning, how do they feel about the day ahead of them? How would you spend your time in your ideal day? You see, it's a lot more about focusing on the way you feel, the things that you would actually do in your day every single day. To fly a private jet, go skydiving, take exotic vacations, and to have fast cars, they're all great things to have, but they're not something that's going to fulfill you every single day. So what you want to do is design your life so you're fulfilled and happy with your life every day, 7 days a week. What you really need to do is to take the time to really think about the things that are most important to you. How would you spend your time and what things would you be involved with your day? For me, what I've come to realize in my working life is that it's really important for me to be working on things that I'm extremely passionate about. And when I do that, I feel alive, I feel energized. Whereas when I'm working on things that I'm not passionate about, I often feel tired and low energy. For me, when I design my average day, I think about where I would want to be working. What would that environment look like? What sorts of things would I want to be working on? What time would I wake up? What sort of food would I be putting into my body? And when and what sort of exercise would I be doing? Who would I be spending my ideal day with? Now each year, and sometimes two or three times a year, I look at my days and really just check back in with myself to see how I'm spending my days and reassess if I'm being true to my vision. When you really get clear on your vision, you're much more able to make sure you don't get distracted and go off on tangents or down rabbit holes by starting opportunities or doing things that aren't congruent with your ideal day in life. Here's an example. If an opportunity or work situation means you're going to be away from your family for an extended period, and one of your principles for your ideal day is to be spending more time with the family, then chasing the money and chasing that opportunity, sure, may bring you the dollars, but ultimately, when you look at your vision, there's going to be a disconnect here, because one of the values you highlighted in your ideal day is to be able to enjoy more time with the family. Then clearly by following that opportunity will ultimately lead you to a place of more frustration and dissatisfaction due to not wanting to spend time doing that as you want. So that's why it's my first principle, to get very, very clear on your vision and to commit to it.